डीआरडीओ। कैन यू हियर मी प्रॉपरली?
यस सर, यस।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, रिस्पेक्टेड सीनियर साइंटिस्ट डीआरडीओ एंड चीफ गेस्ट फॉर टुडेज इवेंट डॉक्टर आर राजेंद्रन सर, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर डॉक्टर एस बी कोटारेड्डी सर, ऑनरेबल रजिस्ट्रार डॉक्टर सी एल बी शिवकुमार सर, कीनोट स्पीकर्स एंड डेलीगेट्स, कन्वेनर ऑफ द इवेंट एंड एचओटी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स डॉक्टर मधुसूदन राव, ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मेंबर्स, फैकल्टी एंड स्टाफ मेंबर्स, रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स एंड माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द स्कूल ऑफ एडवांस साइंसेज वीआईटीपी यूनिवर्सिटी, आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सटेंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू यू ऑल इन द टू डे नेशनल वर्कशॉप ऑन रिसेंट ट्रेंड्स एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन फिजिक्स। टूडे वी आर एक्सट्रीमली ऑनर्ड टू हैव विथ अस टूडेज चीफ गेस्ट डॉक्टर आर राजेंद्रन, साइंटिस्ट जी, एयरक्राफ्ट प्रोजेक्ट डिविजन एंड कॉम्बैट व्हीकल्स, रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट एस्टेब्लिशमेंट, डिफेंस रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डीआरडीओ चेन्नई। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर यूनिवर्सिटी आई एक्सटेंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू यू सर। वी आर डिलाइटेड टू हैव विथ अस ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर ऑफ वीआईटीपी यूनिवर्सिटी डॉक्टर एस बी कोटारेड्डी सर। ही इज अ ग्रेट विजनरी। His dream is to place VITAP University in top 200 universities of the world. Sir, under your great leadership, our university will cross all milestones. A hearty welcome to you, sir. We are greatly honored to have with us Dr. CLB Shivakumar, our beloved registrar, sir. Since inception, sir has supported and guided us in every aspect to make every initiative to a success. A hearty welcome to you, sir. A warm welcome to all speakers, delegates from reputed institutes and industries, all participants from 16 states and 3 union territories of India, participants from China and Abu Dhabi. A cordial welcome to all school deans, section heads, faculty and staff members, organizing members, research scholars and students. Thank you.
Next, as part of the event, we have Dr. Madhusudan Rao, head of the Department of Physics, giving an overview of the workshop. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. The distinguished dignitaries of today's inaugural session, chief guests and learned colleagues, invited speakers, students, research scholars, and all section heads of the VIT University, and my dear participants of the workshop, very good morning to all. At the outset, as a convener of the workshop and the head of the Department of Physics, it's my immense pleasure to welcome everyone to the inaugural session of the two-day national workshop on recent trends and opportunities in physics. I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to our beloved, to our Honorable Chancellor, Dr. G. Vishwanathan sir, our beloved Vice President, Dr. Sekhar Vishwanathan sir, respected Vice Chancellor, Dr. S. V. Kotareddy sir, our dynamic Registrar, Dr. C. L. V. Shivakumar sir, and Dean of School of Advanced Sciences, Dr. Shantan Mandal, for their help and organizational support to conduct this workshop. My deepest thanks and regards to our chief guest, Dr. R. Rajendran sir, for accepting our invitation and honoring us with his esteemed presence. I also thank all invited speakers of the workshop for their willingness to share their professional experience and insight in this platform. The workshop will bring together leading physicists, engineers, scientists from national institutes and organizations to share and exchange insights into trends in current research and challenges in physics and its prospects in cutting edge technologies. The workshop particularly wishes to engage student participants to get introduced to diverse fields and opportunities in physics. And it is being organized to in two levels. In all, 8 eminent speakers from different organizations and institutes like DRDO, ISRO, IITs, Central University, and from solar industry also are delivering their talk. The first level to be conducted today will focus on novel approaches and opportunities in physics, and the second level to be held on 17th April will focus on physics of advanced materials. I'm happy to share that over 939 participants, including students, researchers, and faculty across 16 Indian states and 3 union territories and 2 foreign countries have registered for the event. The Department of Physics at VIT AP University has faculty members working on diverse aspects of condensed matter and material science, ranging from nanomaterials, photonics, polymers, photovoltaics, optoelectronics to biological physics. Currently, there are 11 research scholars in the department pursuing their PhD degree. I would like to take this opportunity to inform you that apart from its PhD degree program, the department is set to offer a master's program in physics to commence in the upcoming fall semester starting July of this year. The program offers specializations in frontline areas and aim to develop an application and technology-oriented learning along with an in-depth training in the core classical areas of physics. It is designed with a combination of theoretical, experimental, and project-based learning components. I would especially like to request the students, undergraduate and postgraduate students, participants of the workshop to consider the opportunity of pursuing master's and PhD program at VIT AP University and invite them to take a look at our website for further details. With this, I would like to welcome everyone again to this workshop. We look forward to an exciting series of talks from the speakers and enthusiastic participation from the attendees, and sincerely hope that the event will be a memorable experience for one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Next, we have the presidential address, and I request our Vice Chancellor, Dr. S.V. Kottareddy, sir, to give the presidential address. Over to you, sir.
Good morning. Dr. R. Rajendra, Aircraft Project Division, Combat Research, Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, Chennai. Minister of VIT AP University, Dr. S. Kumar, keynote speaker, delegates from India and abroad. It is with great pleasure that I welcome you all to this special workshop on recent trends and opportunities. It is a workshop level 1 on 10th April and on 17th April for PG students. My hearty congratulations to the School of Advanced Sciences. I'm glad to inform you that the school is organizing several national in very short span. In the series, The first national workshop on data sciences was organized on 13th March. It was for 5 days, and Honorable Education Minister Shri Adimulap Suresh Garu actually inaugurated that. And Chancellor Sir and VP Sir and other dignitaries have participated in that event. More than 2,000 delegates participated in that event. It was a big success. Now today is workshop on physics, and this is for 2 days, as mentioned, 17th and 18th April. And the school also is planning to organize national level workshop on chemistry. And I think that will be held on 17th and 18th April. And then I would like to congratulate the school once again for organizing such national importance events. And these all events are participants are many. Many participants are participating. Actually, this is a great success of the school. And on this occasion, I want to advise the students. Dear students, you should be innovative. You should think out of box. Now, being physics graduates and PG students, now you are not less than any engineering students. Now, therefore, you should have the innovative ideas like engineering students, and you should implement new ideas, and you should actually do the projects with new ideas. I would like to share one of my experiences when I was doing a PhD in IIT Bombay. This is actually to encourage you towards innovative thinking. IIT Bombay organizes the Innovative Idea Competition every year. And I'm talking about 20 years back story. And then actually the student participate in that event with great enthusiasm. They come up with new ideas and new innovations, and they present in that competition. And some of the ideas that time when they were presenting, I was thinking whether it is possible or not. Not only me, many people were thinking that those ideas may not be possible. Okay, then just I wanted to mention one of the ideas they presented was how to optimize the travel time of local train in Mumbai. You all know that lakhs of people every day travel in local trains of Mumbai, and they stop in every station for few seconds and then move on. But IIT Bombay student wanted to even optimize that the time when the train is stopped. That time also they want to optimize. They said that idea was no need to stop the train. The platform has to move along with the train. Suppose if the train is coming at 80 kilometers per hour of speed, the platform also should move along with the train with 80 kilometers per hour of speed, so that passengers can come down. And at the same time, passengers can get into the train. This was the idea. But at that time, many people said that, no, how this idea is possible, it is impossible. I mean, how to make the moving platform and all those things. But what I want to tell you is that, and that point of time, we may think that this idea may not work, but later on it will come true. In the same competition, they were presenting about the solar planes, and they were talking about the flying vehicles, and they were talking about the unmanned cars, get that driverless cars. You know, like this, there are so many ideas were presented. But many of those ideas are coming true. What I want to tell you is that don't, think that, okay, this idea may not be possible, but today it may not be possible, but tomorrow it is possible. That is what the think out of the box. That's what I wanted to mention to you. And see, many times what happens when we are presenting these ideas, we will have the naysayers also from behind. They will say, our own colleagues or our own, the friends, they will say, no, don't present such ideas. These are all stupid ideas and it won't work. I call them as naysayers. Okay, they say everything is impossible in the world. But what I want to tell you is, everything is possible in the world. Nothing is impossible. And therefore, dear students, you should come out with the innovative technologies, innovative thinking, and innovative technologies, and you should implement those. You should start doing some prototypes, and then try to get into the product level. Okay, then be careful about naysayers. I wanted to caution you on that, and definitely you will be successful if you don't listen to the naysayers. And then at VITAP University, we encourage our faculty and students to get innovative ideas. We are planning to organize what I mentioned was NIT Bombay. Now also they organize these innovative competitions. And in VITAP University also, we have been organizing these competitions, and we will actually enhance further on this innovative ideas competitions. So that we will get more and more ideas, and then we can get into the projects. Our focus at VITAP University is research and innovation, as I mentioned. And to enhance the research output, we have taken several initiations. On this occasion, I would like to tell you some of the initiations. As of now, the first initiation is that how to enhance the research output. Now, as of now, we have published around 325 papers in the Scopus Index journals, with the H index of 16. As a new university, it is a good achievement, but however, we are striving for more number of quality papers in Scopus Index journals. Our aim is to publish more than 3000 papers in the next 5 years. That means it is 10 times what we are publishing at present. Okay, then not only that, the H index also we are aiming to increase to 25. Then I'm confident that with the efforts of our faculty and staff, faculty and the students, we will be able to achieve this. The second point I want to tell you is that, second initiation is that we are providing the internal research funding. Suppose we get, in the competition, if any good ideas are coming, and we provide the funding to make a prototype or to continue that research work. And also, actually, our faculty and staff members are writing the proposals to various government agencies and industry for the research grants. And we support faculty members to present papers in national and international conferences. We provide the funding for that. We are organizing the national and international conferences. Actually, in fact, today, after this inauguration, we have to attend another inauguration. The School of Law is organizing one national conference. We are going to inaugurate that immediately after this. You know, all schools, seven schools in VITAP University are organizing these national and international conferences. You know, the main objective of these national and international conferences is that they provide the platform for the students and faculty members to share their research findings. And this is a great platform for the conferences are great platform for researchers. Then afterwards, actually, they have to move on to the publishing the papers in Scopus Index journals and then patents, etc. But now some of the conferences what we already planned and the dates also are finalized. The first conference is the Public Health Policy, Law and Right Perspective, 10th April today. It's going to be organized by the School of Law. Then the fourth international conference on computational intelligence and data engineering. This is actually scheduled on 13th and 14th August 2021. This will be organized by School of Computer Science and Engineering. Then artificial intelligence and signal processing, that will happen in November 2021. This is organized by School of Electronics, then Indian Society of Theoretical and Applied Mechanics. In December it will happen. This will be organized by the School of Mechanical Engineering. and international conference on advances in mechanical engineering and material sciences. This will be organized by School of Mechanical Engineering. Now, like this, all the schools of VITAP University is planning to organize the national and international conferences. And another good initiative is that we are in the process of establishing 6 centers of excellence with the state-of-the-art equipment for advanced research. And these centers are AI and robotics, IoT, cybersecurity, image and signal processing, renewable energy, additive manufacturing, and so on. These centers are being established with the collaboration of industries and international universities. Another area of our focus is that innovation and incubation. Our faculty members are aiming to file more than 160 patents in 1 year time. Actually, this will be a biggest achievement. And this actually started 2 months back, but already we got 60 ideas for filing the patents. I'm confident that in 1 year, we'll be able to file these 160 patents with the commitment of our faculty and students. Definitely, we will achieve this. And if we do this, then probably we will be the first university in Andhra Pradesh to file 160 patents in single year. Definitely, this will be a biggest achievement for VITAP University. And also, we are allocating more than 10,000 square feet area in innovation and incubation center in our central block. We are giving the greatest importance for this, and we wanted to start the Atal Innovation and Incubation Center in our VITAP University. And another initiation is that recruiting the good research scholars. Now, basically, these research scholars are helping our faculty members to publish the papers. And we are recruiting these research scholars with a monthly stipend. So now, they are getting the amount every month, they get like salary, and they are working closely with our faculty members. As on today, we have 272 research scholars. Okay, then our plan is to recruit 1500 research scholars in next 5 years. But that definitely, with the great vision of our Chancellor sir and VP sir and Executive Director madam, we will be able to achieve this target. And I don't want to take some more time. Okay, before I conclude, I would like to appreciate the efforts of Dr. Shantanu Mandal, Dean School of Advanced Sciences, Dr. Madhusudan Rao, coordinator for this workshop, and his team members, other faculty and staff members, and students to organize this workshop successfully. I wish you all the very best. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Next, I request Dr. V.R.K. Murthy, a professor emeritus at VITAP University, to introduce our chief guest. Over to you, sir. Murthy, sir.
Madhusudan, sir. You can introduce and then next.
We lost touch with Murthy, sir. I now request Pasha, sir. If you're there, can you please introduce the chief guest?
Okay, ma'am. Madhusudan, sir, you please unmute. I think your microphone is mute.
Is someone coming? I'm very pleased to introduce our today's chief guest, Dr. Rajendran sir. Dr. Raju Rajendran sir joined the Defense Research and Development Organization in 1984. After completing bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering from University of Madras and master's and doctoral degree from IIT Madras, he developed empirical, analytical, and numerical methods for underwater explosion damage of ship panels and ambient temperature underwater explosion bulge set of submarine pressure hull. Methodologies developed for predicting underwater explosion damage went into design guidelines of International Ship Structure Committee in ultimate strength and academic damage accidental damage subcommittee reports. Experiments on underwater explosion cavitation served as a benchmark for the development of theoretical models across the world. Dr. Rajendran worked for land-based nuclear submarine development from 2000. He developed nuclear transportation, gas drop test, and energy absorber, established structural integrity of nuclear shut-off rod through stress wave propagation studies, measured residual stress in submarine pressure hull, validated biological shield tank design, and developed shock qualification methodology for nuclear fuel bundle. He carried out predictive maintenance of 82 rotating and 8 reciprocating machinery through vibration condition monitoring. He brought out a noise mapping of the prototype nuclear submarine for adherence of the operating team to the occupational safety and health hazard standards by the way of implementation of noise protection. Dr. Rajendran's contributions on energy absorption propagation is shut off rods entered into International Nuclear Information System Respiratory of International Atomic Energy Agency with Vienna, Australia. Dr. Rajendran worked on aero engine materials technology from 2009. He established dynamic elastic properties, strain adhering exponents and strength coefficients, developed low thermal conductivity, thermal barrier coatings, established engine component condition assessment and mechanical behavior of coatings. Dr. Rajendran developed surface science and engineering laboratory. He developed metal joints and coatings for small engines. The reverse engineering approach established by Dr. Rajendran to obtain the strain adhering component and strength coefficient is widely used in aerospace, manufacturing and steel construction industries. Dr. Rajendran has been working on mechanical filters, aircraft secondary power and undercarriage systems from June 2007. He is responsible for technology development and management and productive delivery. Dr. Rajendran was the editorial board member of Indian Journal of Material Science. He is reviewer of several international journals. He has been a member of several national committees for the development of basic science and technology projects. He has more than 40 international peer-reviewed journals, journal papers, and 3 patents of his credit. Dr. Rajendran has been credited with the DRDO Best Innovation Futuristic Development 2013 Award. So with this, I request Dr. Rajendran sir to give his address. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for the introduction. I now request Dr. R. Rajendran, the chief guest, to give the inaugural address. Over to you, sir.
Sir, please
Rajendran,
unmute.
Sir, you're on mute, sir. Rajendran, sir.
Yes, fine.
Thank you, sir. Yes.
Yeah, now, am I audible, please?
Yes, sir, very much.
Yeah. Vice Chancellor Dr. S.V. Kotareddy, sir. Chairperson and Dean of School of Advanced Sciences, Santanu Mandal, Doctor. Convener and Head of the Department of Physics, Professor Madhusudan Rao. Eminent speakers, members of the organization committee, delegates, leading physicists, engineers, and scientists faculty members, supporting staff, and my dear students. It gives me immense pleasure to be the chief guest for the inauguration of the National Workshop on Recent Trends in and Opportunities in Physics. It's an honor for me to be the part of VITAP for this event. We all know physics is a science of matter and motion, space, time, and energy. Physics view together observation, experiments, and theoretical constructs into coherent mesh of understanding the world around us. Why do we learn physics? Physics helps us to understand the world around us and fulfills our curiosity. Studying physics develops one critical skills and problem solving capabilities. And physics is a global enterprise, so one can get job abroad. And physics drives the technology achievements and economy of a country. We see physics in daily life, just to cite a few, because many of the experts are there in the field. I'll cite very few examples. When we talk about vocal cord vibrates producing sound, and when we eat food, chemical energy is converted to mechanical energy, energy conversion takes place, and the working of our eyes is similar to the working of a camera, which is optics, and we hear because the ear transforms sound waves into internal vibrations. Walking, jogging, and then jumping are associated with the loss of motion of Newton. Now, the connection between physics, technology, and society. A new technologies come in due to scientific breakthrough. The first significant influence of physics on technology was the development of the steam engine, which led to the first industrial revolution. Steam engines works on the principle of thermodynamics, as we all know, and dams, solar panels, wind farms, nuclear reactors are some of the applications of physics in energy sector. Medical industry got benefited by radiology. In communication industry, that is TV and telephone, electromagnetic waves play a vital role, and aircrafts operate on Bernoulli's principle. India had many eminent physicists to contribute to the field of physics. Sir Jagdish Chandra Bose invented wireless communication much ahead of Marconi. The IEEE acknowledged it in 1998. Satyendranath Bose derived new counting procedure for photons, which became Bose-Einstein statistics. Sir C.V. Raman discovered inelastic light scattering effects, which is popularly known as Raman effect. And Homi Bhabha, a nuclear physicist, is the father of Indian nuclear program. He set up TAFR. Vikram Sarabhai, the physicist and astronomer, initiated the Indian space program. Sudarshan contributed to quantum optics. At tachyons, a new kind of particles that travel faster than light, was proposed by Dr. Sudarshan. And Chandrasekhar contributed to the area of black holes. Meghna Astra contributed to the knowledge of pressure and temperature distribution in the stellar atmosphere. Some of the latest innovations in physics, we will look at. There are several new latest innovations in physics. The speakers for this workshop will cover them in detail, and I will cite a very few. Self-healing materials, which are artificially or synthetically created, that have built-in ability to automatically repair damage without external diagnosis of problem or human interventions, can adapt to various environmental situations according to the sensory and actuation properties. And 2D materials, which are of one atom thick, have potential to revolutionize solar cells, transistors, camera sensors, digital screens, monitors. Dr. Chandrasekhar Tiwari is going to talk about it in detail. 3D printing, which is again taking up in a big way, is going to revolutionize the manufacturing field by our capability to make intricate components without going in for casting and welding. 3D printing or additive manufacturing is going to revolutionize the gas turbine field. It is going to revolutionize many manufacturing procedures of intricate components. And semiconductor spintronics, it may be possible for future use of information technology where electron spins used to store, process, and transform information in quantum computers. scientists have achieved electron spin polarization up to 90% at room temperature. How do we prepare physics undergraduates for a career? Only a small percentage of physics undergraduates become professors. So what do the remaining undergraduates do? The vast majority of them is getting employed outside academia. Almost half of the PhD degree holders work outside academics after 1 year of completion of degree. More of them move to private and government sectors after postdoc. Physics graduates working in private sectors regularly need to use skills beyond their knowledge of physics. Working in teams, technical writing, programming, applying physics to interdisciplinary problems, designing and developing products and processes, and then managing complex complex projects are all required skills. But most of the physicists developing them is only a small part of their education experience. How do you prepare the undergraduates for the jobs in the industry? So faculty members ensure that students master physics concepts of the core curriculum. Students also have to gain skills in numerical, analytical, and experimental methods. Studying the subject to develop skill. In addition, students have to apply fundamental physics to interdisciplinary context. When a student enters workplace, he is likely to face challenges of complex, ambiguous problems in real world context. Competence in instrumentation, software, computation, and data analysis is vital to success in key parts of the work of a student. And graduate needs good communication. The graduate has to be persuasive in his communicating the worth of his ideas using words, equations, tables, diagrams, pictures, animations, and other visualization tools. The graduate has to have the ability to communicate his ideas and results to people and to science. So communication is a very important aspect they have to take care. Physics departments can increase skill development into the existing courses or build skills permanently with co-curricular activities. The content of any course should result in career relevant application while maintaining focus on fundamentals. Writing and editing skill of student can be cultivated through English and communication departments. Basic business concepts can be learned through engineering departments and business schools. What can a master's degree in physics give students? There is a general notion that students taking master's degree, they take master's degree because they did not get attractive job offers. For many qualifications, a master's degree student can get confidence from struggling with and solve real world problems. The master's degree helps students research. The ability to create knowledge is different from the ability to understand the existing knowledge, as the former demands high level of imagination and consistent effort to visualize things. The master's degree strength and deepen that. But a master's degree can go into a range of fields like scientist, project manager, and jobs with engineering titles. The workshop covers novel approaches and opportunities in physics and physics of advanced materials in a span of 2 days. There are extraordinary speakers who will enlighten us with their insights into the topics. It's a great opportunity for the students to interact with them to gain immensely. I wish the workshop a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your work wisdom passed on to our students as well. I now request our registrar, sir, Dr. C.L. Vishwakumar, to propose the vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Good morning to all. This is an immense occasion to propose the vote of thanks on the occasion of the National Workshop on the Importance of Physics. This is a real time to discuss the subject physics and to achieve a lot more in the days to come in the building of the nation. The budding engineers As rightly our Vice Chancellor sir said, this is not only for the engineers, physics students particularly. The ideas are supposed to come out of the box. I am very much thankful to our respected Vice Chancellor sir for his thoughtful, interesting and inspiring speech during his presidential address. I sincerely thank, on behalf of the University Administration, the chief guest of the day, Dr. R. Rajendran, scientist DRDO, who is in Chennai today, who readily accepted our invitation to bless our students, scholars, and participants who participated from across the country and other countries too. Sir, Rajendran sir's speech is very, very, very interesting and very thought-provoking. This is really from a person who is down to the earth to see a simple person, but his limitations are at high level. The way in which he achieved lot more laurels for the nation through his contributions in this area is really indicative and inspiring to the participants of the day. This is a real interesting to see about 900 plus participants from 16 states, 3 union territories and 2 countries participated in this program. Very, very thankful to all the people, and I really congratulate that really they are going to learn a lot more during this 2-day workshop. Distinguished speakers from DRDO, ISRO, various IITs, central universities, and solar industry. We are all thankful to all the professors very respectfully for their time in participating in this 2-day workshop. I sincerely thank and appreciate our Dean, School of Advanced Sciences, Dr. Mandal, for his initiatives and active role in generating schemes and programs for implementing and executing this kind of conferences and workshops for the benefit of scholars, students, and faculty too. Thank you, sir, for your initiatives. And I sincerely appreciate the timely coordination of this workshop, Dr. Madhusudhan, the HOD of the Physics Department and coordinator of this workshop. Thank you, sir. I sincerely thank and appreciate the scholars, students, faculty, and staff members attended this conference with a lot of interest in learning the subject physics and to practice tomorrow. I sincerely appreciate and thank the PR office, purchase office, finance office, and the last but not the least, press and media for their wide coverage of this event. I sincerely thank the program moderator, Dr. Susmita, for her time in making this event grand success on the screen. And off the screen, Dr. Sam, Samuel Johnson is there, who is also moderating behind the screen. I am thankful to all the people who are all successfully running this show in the interest of the nation of tomorrow's. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I thank all of you and those who joined for this inaugural session. Now, the event would continue on the MS Teams platform. The links have been shared with you all. Please log in to MS Teams and then the technical sessions begin from there. For students, please copy-paste the link onto the browser if it's not working for you, and see you all on MS Teams shortly. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rajendran, sir. Thank you, VC.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Muthi, sir.
Thank you.
Madhu, sir. Thank you, sir. Can I stop recording?
Thank you. Yes, sir. It's over,
sir. Can I stop? Yes, sir. I'll upload it and send it.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, Santanu, sir.
Can you hear me?
Thank you, Rajendran, sir.
Rajendran, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, very clearly.
In the coming future, if possible, you please visit our campus once pandemic over, then if situation will be stable, then
yes,
campus right now. Okay, please, you please come.
I want to visit my sister labs and then some companies also for overseeing the work progress. I'll make a visit to your campus.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for your kind accepting your invitation.